Welcome to Enots Engineering, I'm Alan. In today's video we finish off making the adapter with a boring head. This is the finished item. Number 2 morse taper and a 1.5 inch 18 UNF thread on this end. Last week's video we prepared the blank and we're setting up to do the morse taper. Now in this week's video I had a problem that I didn't have the change gear needed to produce 18 teeth per inch as recommended on the Boxford list. So I went on to a little program that Evan has made that will give you the information you need for all South Bend Boxfords and the derivatives of those lathes with or without a gearbox, metric or imperial. You feed the information in, say what gears you've got, and it will give you a list of the gears that will cut the thread you need. And if not, how accurate or how near to that thread you can get. So it's worth looking at. I'll put a link at the beginning of the video data information so you can go onto the website and have a look. So let's go into the workshop, see how we do it. First of all, we'll have a look at the setup. I'm about to turn a number 2 morse taper. So I've taken the component, held it with a driving dog, put a centre in this end, which is a fixed centre, so that rotates with the head, put my driving plate on and a pin. Let me turn this round. There's the pin in there so it touches the dog. Now this is not the normal driving dog I use. Normally I'll use something like this. But in this case I haven't got one that's a big enough diameter. I'll show you this. This is what I used to use on grinding machines. And it's just two square pieces of steel, two cap heads through. That clamps on the diameter. And then as long as you can get onto the driving pin, that will drive the component. Being a number 2 morse taper, I need to taper it down. This end's small, this end big. So I'll check the run out here. It's about 3 thou. You can see it's running out for more down here. This is running out about 6 thou. There are two ways you can machine the morse taper. The first way is using your compound slide, set the angle and just cut winding along the compound slide. And the problem with this is you have to do a lot of winding your compound slide in and out. Because on this machine the compound slide is about 2.5 inches. And that morse taper will use nearly all of the 2.5 inches. So you'll be winding from one end of your compound slide to the other and trying to get a good finish. Now what I usually do is pull the tailstock over to give me the angle, and then I can use my traverse as normal. I'll get a better finish, a constant feed. Now on the Boxford there are two grub screws each side of the tailstock base, and you just slacken one off, tighten the other one, and it will pull the tailstock over. Obviously I need to come towards a tool to get the taper. So I've set my dial indicator to 0 on the end of the component, or a few millimeters in, and work calculating the distances. I need to move this 64th thou towards the dial indicator. So what I will do is move it 50 thou, turn down, and then test it on a morse taper sleeve and then adjust it a bit more. Slackening the rear grub screw on my tailstock and tightening up the front one to pull the centre over 64th thou.
So we'll go to 50 and then tighten the grub screw back up on the rear of the tailstock. So now you should be able to see there's a slope on there of 20 thou. So I'll put the tool in and I'll just turn this. .74 .79 is my morse taper that I want to copy, number 2 on the inside. So that's, I'm using this as the gauge. It's just starting to go in. So I have a lot to come off there, so what I'll do is move the angle out that extra 10 thou that I didn't do at the beginning. So if I just swap this for my dial indicator, there's the 10 thou. Okay, that red line is the length of the morse taper, so that should be 700 where the red line is, 0.7. And it's 30 thou over, and this should be 572 at the bottom, roughly, and that's 100 thou over, so I need to pull it over another 20 or 30 thou using the tailstock. Put some micrometer blue on. Touching there, there, and here. Bit heavy on there. Part. I've just blued it up. See where it's marking. You can see it's marked there, there, and down there. So it's spread over the length. You can see the end just comes into the opening on the tang, so you can use a drift to get that off if needed. I think this is still quite warm. So I'll let it cool down and just double check it before I dismantle my settings. Now on the very end I've just turned a little bit of the diameter parallel and put a chamfer on this end, because if you use a drift to knock the taper out and there's a sharp corner, you just put a dent in the corner. I've got two number 2 morse taper sleeves. The first one, you can see inside there, it goes down, fits okay, doesn't need the tang putting on. The second one, it goes down, but the tang needs to be put on the end because it's fouling on the very end. So that's not gripping on the taper. So to get that to grip, I'd have to machine two little flats on the side to form the tang. But I'm not worried about that because the main thing I'm going to use it on is my tail stock, and that fits into my tail stock and wide it out a bit. Grips. And then when I undo my tail stock, as it gets to zero, there, it's just ejected it. So that works fine on my tail stock. The setup for the screw cutting, still got the centre in this end and the drive pin, drive plate, and I've put a small drive dog on the end where I turn the parallel surface. That just grips on there so I can turn the thread. This end still the same revolving centre. I've checked the run out of this, it's about a thou. This is where I'm going to cut the thread. So all that is the same. The only difference is obviously I've returned the tailstock to the zero position, so it's parallel now rather than at a angle. Now bearing in mind that my Boxford is a metric lathe, the lead screw has a 3mm pitch, so I'll need to convert metric to imperial because this is 18 teeth per inch I'm trying to cut. So to do that I will need to fit a compound gear, and the compound gear has 135 teeth on the outside, 127 teeth on the inside. Then I'd need to fit a stud gear which is 32 teeth, and then the lead screw which is 64 teeth, and that should give me 18 teeth per inch, 32 stud, 64 lead screw. Now the problem I have is I don't have a 64 tooth gear. I have a 232s at the bottom, 232 tooth, 48, 60, 56, an 80, 72, but no 64. So the next thing I need to do is calculate which other gears will give me the same pitch. Now if you want to find out what pitch you can cut with different gears, Evans made a little program that suits the Boxford and the South Bend and all the other different varieties of South Bends, and it will calculate the gears to use for the pitch you want using the lead screw that you have. Now that's the back of the Boxford with all the gears removed, so I'll add the gears to cut the 18 teeth per inch. So first we add the 30 tooth, then the 135127, and finally 60 tooth. What I've done is put an undercut in here so that it's clear. I put some red marker on there so I can see the cut. I'll set my lathe tool square, which has a thread cutting insert at 60 degree. We've set the gears up so I get the 18 teeth per inch. So the first thing I want to do is put a fine cut on and just check that I have got 18 teeth per inch. That's my first cut. Zero my cross slide. Disconnect it, move it across. I have a thread gauge with 18 teeth per inch on it. Should be that.
That looks okay.
Problem there. That doesn't look as if it's got on the same track.
So it doesn't look as if I can use my thread dial on that.
So I'll have to do the old way where you forward and reverse. That's the boring head I want to fit. There we go, job done. Locks up on the head. Okay, I'll take a sharp corner off the edge there where the thread is. Finished job. Two morse taper and a 1.5 inch 18 UNF.
Oh well, that's it for today. Thanks for watching. I hope that was useful. Hope you enjoyed it, and we'll see you next time on Enots Engineering.